wearing right now, this is basically a very nice Indian traditional look. So we know that Rakhi is coming up in August, so I thought, you know, why not just sit down, make a very nice Indian traditional look. And I actually had another motive to do this. So basically the products which I have used to achieve this look is from this amazing brand called Bharat & Doris. So this is an amazing brand which is Mumbai based, and it carries a huge variety and a huge range of makeup products and makeup tools and brushes, and you name it, they have it. They're also a very successful running institute. So I had gone to Mumbai for further professional training in makeup and hairstyling, because you know, you can just never stop learning, and I just wanted to learn more. And I found out that it was the most sought after makeup institute by everyone over there. So the teachers over there, the faculty, are basically celebrity makeup artists, and I think that's amazing. So during my stay over there, I actually came across a lot of cool stuff, a lot of cool makeup products which they carry. So I thought, you know what, let me just gather and assemble all the products which I think are really nice from the whole range, from the whole makeup range which they carry, and you know, share it with you guys and create a makeup look with it, so that you guys can, you know, also take advantage of what good is there in the market. Believe me, some of the products which they carry are even better than the most sought after luxury makeup brands which we have nowadays. And the products which I will be mentioning in my video, I have actually been using them for more than 3 months now. I'm 100% honest in my reviews, and I am only bringing those products in front of you guys which are tried and tested by me and which are 100% certified by me. And these products are beyond amazing. So this is how this video is going to work. I am going to be recreating the look. I'm going to be using many more products too, and products from Bharat & Doris itself. And while I'm using the products, I will be reviewing them. I will be telling you what I feel about them. Once again, they won't be first impressions, because I have been using them since a long time now. But then again, they will be sort of a on trial kind of a review. They are a super, super affordable brand, and they're very easily available. You can find them on Nykaa, on Facebook, on Instagram. I'm going to leave all the details down below, so please don't forget to check the description box. And I really think that this is an amazing brand. I have been working with this brand. I have been working this brand up on my face for like 3 months. But then again, I couldn't really review a lot of products in this video, so I bought only my personal favorites into this video. So I will be reviewing them, and I will be using them on my face, so you can actually see how to work them up. So if you guys want to know how to get this look, and if you guys want to know about this amazing brand, then keep watching. Let's not get scared, and please let's excuse my small little sweet Velcro over here. So let's get started. I have actually moisturized my face already off camera, and I used the Soap and Glory Fab Pore Moisturizer. I really don't want to go ahead and prime my skin more, because it's summers and I don't want to add that extra layer on my face. So the next step today will be skipping straight ahead to the foundation. Usually I do concealers first, but today I'll be using a cream foundation, and cream foundations usually take like 10 to 15 minutes to settle in, so I really want to go with my foundation first. For today's look, the foundation which I chose to use is the cream foundation by Bharat & Doris. I think I love the way that the packaging is so amazing, bold and black. I really, really love black packaging. And the best part about this foundation is that it's so light and amazing and portable, because usually, you know, when we are traveling and we have to take those big bottles of foundations, it becomes really inconvenient. But I guess this really nails it for that part, and this is an amazing cream foundation. Usually I'm not really a big fan of cream foundations, but this one has completely changed my view towards them. Let me just show you guys how easy it is to blend this foundation. So I'm just going to swatch it right here, and with very light patting motion. Look at that. I just have to pat it a little bit, and it completely settled in my skin. I think this is seriously amazing. And to find this right kind of formula with cream foundation is so difficult, but then I think they have really, really nailed it. So I'm going to be using the shade Fair Light for my entire skin, and then I'm going to be going in with my concealer. So the moment I have blended it with my hands, I'll go ahead with my damp beauty blender and I'll just gently dab the product in. Honestly, I don't have concealer under my eyes right now, so it might not look even, but otherwise if you avoid the eye area, you can really see that this side is looking more even and settled and matte and shine free, which is really good during summer. So let me go ahead and just finish off my entire face. Whatever dullness that I feel that I have on my skin is instantly covered and corrected by this foundation. So my next step will be putting a cream concealer too. Usually I really like liquidy concealers, but nowadays I have become a huge fan of cream concealers, and cream concealers really do a fab job of covering up your dark circles. So today the concealer which I will be using is the Bharat & Doris cream concealer, and again I love the packaging, and I am using the concealer in shade CS02. The packaging of this one is really nice. It again comes in a very nice pot like this. So what I really love to do with my concealer is I love to take the concealer in my fingers to warm it between my fingers and then put it under my eyes. Now the moment we are done with blending the concealer, we'll actually see that the areas in our eyes where we actually have the darkness gets a bit ashy. So for those points and for the deep points of our eyes, we'll take a very nice burnt orange color like this. I am using a concealer palette from MAC, and it is called the Pro Conceal and Correct palette, and it is in the shade medium deep. So I will be taking a very nice burnt orange color like this so that I can add a little bit of warmth to that ashiness. I will be using this amazing brush from Bharat & Doris, and it is called the Foundation H87 Small. It's basically sort of a stippling brush, but this is small in size, so this is amazing for blending in concealers or for correcting small, you know, discolorations on your face. So I completed my other eye also in the same way. About this concealer, I think I'm really, really excited because usually cream concealers bunch up in my creases and they create very bad crease lines. But I think it's really amazing by far. It has really, really concealed my dark circles. I used another corrector on top of it too, but then still it did not crease up or bake up. So immediately after I have put my concealer, what I love to do is bake my eyes. No. Don't worry, you don't have to microwave your eyes. By baking, I mean you just put like a gunk load of powder, under translucent powder or setting powder under your eyes or wherever you have put the concealer so that it gets completely set and it does not move. So I will be using this amazing translucent loose powder again by Bharat & Doris. So this comes in a packaging like this and you get like a solid 30 grams of product, which I think is a very, very fair deal. I have been using this for over 3 months now and I use it almost every day, and I still have like 3/4 of the product right there, if you can see, which is, I think it's more than 3/4, and it's amazing. Before I put any sort of translucent powder under my eyes or on my face, I first quickly make sure that I don't have any sort of crease already happening. So I'll just run around my stippling brush like this so that I diffuse any sort of crease which has happened under my eyes. And once this is done, I'll just take the beauty blender, the damp beauty blender which I used to blend the foundation on my skin. I'll take a load of product like this and I'll just deposit it under my eyes. And you just let it sit on your face while you do your entire makeup. So this exactly is the smoky eye which I'm trying to achieve for this look. It is a bit intense as I talked about in the beginning, but you can, you know, tone it down according to you. Usually achieving smoky eyes for deep set eyes like me is not really easy. So let me just show you guys how to do it. The first thing which I will be doing is putting NYX eyeshadow base all over my eyelid. And now I will be using the Bharat & Doris Easy Eyeshadow Eye Crayons, and this is in the shade cosmic, and I will be putting the shade all over my lid. I will be blending my lid shade by using my Morphe 35C palette, and I will be mixing this black shade right over here with this brown shade to get the exact lid color that I want. And the brush which I will be using is by Morphe, and it is M411. Once I'm done blending that, I'll go for a much lighter color from the same palette, something like this, and I'll blend out any sort of harsh lines or harsh edges that I think I might have. To do that, I'm using the same brush by Morphe. And now actually I'll go in with the fun part of this eyeshadow, and that is playing with the colors. So over here we have these three very beautiful shades of pink, and I will be basically just juggling through these shades and trying to create a very nice ombre pinkish look. So the first shade which I want to use is something like this. This is a very nice smoked purple color. And for this I really want to use the Sephora Multi-Purpose Crease Brush. Once I'm done blending the smoked purple color, I really want to go with a very nice fun pink color like this. So to really finish the look, I'm going to take a very nice neutral brown shade, and I'm going to blend out the harsh line. So I'm going to go in the same palette, and I'm going to use a very light brown shade like this. Now once I'm done blending the harsh lines, I will be using the amazing Bharatan Doris Smoky Coal Pencil. This is what it looks like, and I love the way it glides. I think it is the best kajal formula I have ever seen, and it's uber black, and it's absolute smudge proof. It has been my go-to kajal pencil for quite a few weeks now, and I will be using this as my liner and as my coal today. Going to take a tip brush like this. Even this is from Bharat & Doris, and it is called a flat smudger, and it is number 32. So I'm just going to take this and rub it all along my lower lash line wherever I have put the kajal. And now I'm going to take the same tip brush and use my crease pink shade to underline my waterline. So once I'm done with my eyes, I'll just take a very nice fan brush like this, and I'll brush off the excess of the powder which I have. So my next step is contouring. So I will be taking my MAC Naturally Enhanced Mineralized Skin Finish Natural Contouring Kit and the Morphe M458 brush, and I'm just going to contour my face. So this is my favorite step of my entire beauty routine. Now I will be actually putting on blush on my cheeks and putting some color on my face. I will be using Bharat & Doris blusher, and it is in the shade 01. I love how metallic this blusher is, and I love the color. Honestly, I really love the consistency of each and everything they have. I don't know if you guys can see the shade, but then this is really very nice and intense. So if you are actually using this blusher, make sure that you're a bit light-handed on it. I will be using the Bharat & Doris blush brush, and it is number T07. So we are almost done with the face. The only step which is left is lipstick, and this is the best pink nude color which I have ever got. I think I really love Meher by MAC, but after this color I think I have really stopped using any other color. This is the Everyday Nude Creamy Lip Crayon again by Bharat & Doris, but I'm not kidding, this is seriously amazing. I'll actually leave the shade of this product down in the description box below, so do check it out. I think this is one of the must-haves in your beauty bag. I am seriously loving the pigment on this lipstick. This is amazing. It's creamy and it glides on so easily. Just look at how creamy this is. I just did one swatch and it is as creamy as ever possible. I am seriously in love with all of these products from Bharat & Doris. I have been trying these products for a long time now. So there you go, this is your whole look. I think this is amazing to sport on Rakhi, and whatever products I have used are easily available on Nykaa. And as far as this look is concerned, this is really very chic and amazing. I hope you guys liked it and this was helpful for you guys. Do check this brand out. I think it's really very affordable. The products are above and beyond better in quality than any other brands which are out there and which are so expensive. And if you guys want me to do more such looks and videos, then please subscribe and do not forget to share and like this video. Thank you, and I'll see you in my next